Good morning, everyone. It's Tuesday, November 13th, and the title for today is The Spirit is Leading. Reports of what happened in Caesarea with Cornelius soon reached the leaders of the Christian community in Jerusalem, and they asked Peter to give an account of what had happened. They were offended by what Peter had done because, according to their Jewish understanding of the law of Moses, faithful Jews were not allowed to eat with Gentiles. Although some raised questions about the legitimacy of Peter's actions and his decisions to baptize these Gentiles, sufficient witness certified that the Holy Spirit indeed manifests his presence in the same way as at Pentecost. The guidance and leading of the Holy Spirit in this case is unassailable, and the gift acknowledged. When they heard these things, they became silent, and they glorified God, saying, "Then God has also granted to the Gentiles repentance to life." Acts 11:18. Perhaps some in Jerusalem thought what had happened was Cornelius and his household would be an exception, and that such an experience would not be repeated. But that's not what the Holy Spirit intended. As the disciples of Jesus scattered beyond Jerusalem and Judea because of the persecution that arose after Stephen's death and went to Samaria, Phoenicia, Cyprus, and Antioch, more and more Gentiles accepted Jesus as their Savior. This is what Jesus had predicted. As wonderful as this influx of Gentiles was, if we put ourselves in the place of these early Jewish believers, it's not hard to see how they weren't quite sure how to react. How might we ourselves be holding on to narrow views of the church and of our message that could hamper our own witness? Please answer in the comment section below. Thank you for watching today. God bless you, and we'll see you tomorrow.